Okay, guys, welcome back again. So again, very, very thankful and grateful to be joined by another great lad. Again, I talk about all these guys that I speak with. I promise to the ladies, we are going to get more women on very shortly. We're obviously going through the lads first and speaking to a lot of guys around the world who have been at high levels of the game of football, soccer, and a man now in Liam Barrett, who actually played at a great level in England, for Ipswich Town, went out to the States and played at Collegiate, had a very good career collegiately, and has now run his own and set up and owns and runs his own collegiate recruitment company, which is great at getting kids out from all kind of levels of sport to the US and vice versa, where kind of kids from the US can go back overseas to the UK and around the world. So Liam, mate, if you want to just kind of, you know, introduce yourself, pal, and take the floor and just talk about your whole career, mate, as a player, and obviously then going out to the States and what that was like, and now your whole role as the main guy as such for this recruitment company, and obviously how it works and what it does, and how people and players can get in contact with you.
Yeah, sure. Obviously, thanks for, I hope the listeners find it helpful. But sure, mate, I'll take you through kind of my journey and how we've ended up to where I am today. But I guess from the start, I've always been obsessed with football from a young age. And then I'm based in Suffolk, in England, for those of you that have visited. Bit of a quiet place. But so I joined the local club there, which is Ipswich Town, and kind of worked my way up from a young age, from like age group of 9 up until being a scholar. And I was there until the age of 19. And during my time as a scholar, the operation, and kind of knew the reality of a professional wasn't going to come to fruition. So it was kind of looking like exit strategies and what I could do with the next step in my life. And kind of on the back end of having the knee surgeries, was actually told that I fundamentally should probably look at maybe even retiring. So at that point, I knew that I wanted to, you know, further my education and try and set myself up for a career. So I was thinking, you know, should I go to university in the UK like my sister? Although, you know, seeing her, she went to UCL in London, seeing her getting a lot of debt, and then thinking, you know, maybe that's not for me either. And then also another thing was, having played at a fairly decent level, was some of my older mates and teammates had gone to uni in the UK, and maybe the football wasn't quite the standard that they'd been used to, or maybe at least not taken as serious. So when I heard about the opportunity of going to America, the opportunity to play, train at a high level, still a very professional environment, and potentially come out of university debt-free, for me, it was an absolute no-brainer. You know, obviously, we send a lot of players to the States now, and obviously, Matt, I'm pretty sure you were in a similar situation where it seemed like an unbelievable opportunity for you. But we also realised it is a massive decision for you. But, you know, believe me and Matt and other people that have been through it, it's the best thing that ever happened to me, because I was at a point where I didn't really know what I wanted to do with my career. And then in terms of my football, I felt that if I did go to uni in the UK, no disrespect to that system, but I felt that, you know, maybe I'd dedicated my life to football and then kind of that was it. So, yeah, I had the opportunity to go out to America, went to a university called the Institute of Technology, which is in Chicago, which at the time was an NAIA school, now an NCAA school. Absolutely loved it. The academics were good. The athletic program was good. There was a lot of international players there. They're located in downtown Chicago. So for me, that whole experience kind of ticked every box from what I wanted to get out of that. So that was incredible. Was it? I had the internet and social media back then, was that probably giving it the large one, posting pictures online, and a few guys that I played with before, and I'm sure you've had this as well, Matt, is that you'll see other guys and they'll think, you know what, I wish I'd have done that, or I'd like to do that as well. So you kind of inadvertently start helping other players go through the same process to try and get them out to America and help them with the next step of their career. So started doing that, and ironically, you know, the relationship and experience out of using a company like ours wasn't great. You know, I had my profile video circulated, and then I think that's pretty much the last I heard from that company. So, you know, getting contact from was great, but with UK young lads and female players, if maybe the name of 50, you know, 60 schools, I don't know, really know where to start in terms of researching them, finding out which ones were good, which ones weren't, and having to even find that I needed to do an SAT exam. I didn't even know I needed to do that right until the last moment. And then having all the coach, it was a field for me, and going out there, I'm really sure what I was walking into, because I hadn't really got a lot of support at all. Then after year one, I mean, I was enjoying it. I was doing fairly well. I had a full tuition scholarship, which was great because it was a very, you know, reputable academic school. And then I had to pay for my food and housing. So after year one, did fairly well, got a few goals, won a few awards, and then had other schools that were interested in me, particularly transfer. Actually, even from a perspective, because of financially supporting the difference in the cost, is that I wanted to explore that and tried to get back in touch with the company that I'd been through, and they wanted more money for me to help with the transfer. So I said, well, just give me the video footage myself and I'll do it. Well, again, they wanted money for the video footage. So to be honest, it was just a complete nightmare and headache, and it just very, very much felt that I was just a number in the system and there to make money from. So again, when we decided to set this company up, kind of back end of me graduating, and a few of my colleagues who had also had bad experiences, we wanted to start up a company that was completely different, that provided service as players into the program. But it wanted. That's how, well, what was US Soccer Scholarship started, with branches in sports now. And kind of our business model has always been to be very selective. We get over applications, but our male and female soccer cohort to just 50 players, and the reason being is just taking learning. You know, myself even was one of 300 and not getting that personal support. So that's two ways. As a got a reputation, so coach actually come from a player perspective, you're really guided every element. As a bucket here, I've kind of done the, I've not had. So now, obviously, with the support, not only we're just being helping the scholar, Matt, justified these times having your own out there, but also with transfers, well, there's a lot to it, not only, you know, practicing for the SAT exam and passing that, registering and making sure you're eligibility to, you know, making sure that you've got a financial deal for you that's right. So does it cover things like tuition increases? Can you possibly get a job included within that to help reduce your costs further? Also beyond that, you know, assistance with getting through admissions and then your visa as well. So it really is kind of like a, from a day one to through when your graduation, we want to support our players with every aspect of that. And kind of a good example of that, which I was talking to you about the other day, Matt, was a guy we had called Matt Bentley at Colchester United, who Matt got released just before scholarship. Great player, raw talent, very academic kid, ideal for the American college system. And so he went out on, I believe, a full scholarship to a D2 program in West Virginia. Absolutely loved his time. After 3 years, was actually getting a lot of interest from programs and had been playing in summer leagues, as he genuinely thought that going pro could be an option for him at the end of it. After 3 years, we were able to get in a transfer to Missouri State, which is obviously a top D1 program. I believe they went 18-0 during regular season, just gone. And that just helped put him on a different platform. Obviously, games are shown on ESPN, a lot of scouts, a lot of attention. So, and then on the back end of that, he did get drafted into Minnesota United this summer. So, you know, it's a good success story for us, but also just highlights, regardless of what you're looking to do beyond graduating, whether it's becoming an assistant coach or going into the pro game or coming back to the UK, we're there for you and your family the whole way. And another kind of good example of that is a female player we've got called Ellie Rossiter. She was playing for Ipswich women's team, went out to the States. We supported her for a whole 4 years. She's come back and we helped her. She's got back playing for Ipswich ladies, which is great for them as well. But also now she helps with recruitment for our women's side. So it really is like a family community that we make sure that we're there for them the whole way. So it's not just, you know, a situation like me where my video was circulated and then I was having to do a lot of the legwork. And then during the times when I did need help, there was always a cost to it. So that's kind of the key ways that we try to operate. And then beyond that, some really exciting developments we've had just beyond our actual service is that if you go on our website right now, which is ussportsscholarships.com, we've just launched and improved our athletes area. Now, for a signed player, as well as having a designated representative, so whether that's myself or if you're in the States, Matt, looking after you through the whole our experience, also get you to the site where process time, you through everything to get done, but also helpful tips and resources and videos on there. And if you want just the online player package, so for any of you listening, whether you're in the US or the UK, the online package gives to 1,000 university coaches within the UK and the six forms, you know, finish thinking you're not sure what to do. This is a great resource just to search by divisions, search by state, country, and university that maybe you're interested in, and what campus video, you know, look into information about the background, the location of the school, the academic requirements, and you can even obviously directly contact coaches as well. So that's a new development, and again, for me, that just came from my personal experience of not really knowing which universities would be a good fit for me. So we're just trying to give players all tools that they need so that they arrive at the right decision. Because another thing that happened with me, and Matt, I think you had the same situation, was that when I was, my video was circulated, all the interesting offers that were coming back from American colleges left me with, say, for example, $7,000 a year, always the same amount. And the reason being is the company I went through, I kind of said to them, that's my max of what I could afford to contribute towards my cost. So obviously they'd told the coaches that as well. And, you know, if I'm a coach and I know, you know, Matt, that you can afford that, I'm going to be an idiot to offer you anything less than that. So we'd never disclose any financial information about our players. We always kind of go to bat for them as if they can afford nothing, essentially. And you have to add some more legwork in terms of negotiations and kind of play in universities to get the best deal. It's that type of personal touch and additional support that we provide. Say, for example, it helps, you know, secure an extra $2,000 or $3,000 a year for a player. We might have effectively just saved them, you know, over $10,000 during their 4 years while they're out there. So that's kind of how we've worked for a number of years, and we've got development squads now in the UK, in Suffolk, and also in Hertfordshire, both men's and women's soccer, and just really been able to grow the program lately. So if you're listening in the UK, and obviously I've mentioned that we're in the south, we've also got trial games, because we're partnered with Football Industry College in St George's Park. We've got trial games in Sheffield coming up, Liverpool, Sunderland, Norfolk, London. So literally all throughout the UK, also in Dublin, Ireland. So really, you know, there's a lot of opportunities to come and meet with us, play in front of us, obviously learn more about the process, albeit once normality is restored and we're able to go out again. And then obviously I've talked about the soccer side of things a lot, but you know, as I alluded to earlier, we've now branched out to other sports as well. But the key thing for us was, yes, the process can be quite similar for recruitment, but we wanted people involved in the business that were specialists within their area. So our head of rugby's done an international scholarship himself, same with our head of golf, same with our head of tennis as well. So, you know, we want to make sure that we've got the right people in place that, you know, like yourself, Matt, have been through the process. They know the ins and outs of it. They know the highs and lows of it as well, because, you know, it's easy to sit here and say what an incredible opportunity it is to play as a college athlete in America, which it is. You know, the opportunity to travel to various locations, play at a high standard, play in front of a lot of people, progress your game, train regularly, get a degree. This is all great. But also there's a lot of pitfalls in the sense that, you know, we get academy guys particularly who maybe they get approached by a school and they think, yeah, that sounds good for me, I'll go for it. But is it the right school that's for you? You know, there's over 2,500 universities that could be a good fit for you. And I'm sure if you're an American student listening now, you wouldn't just go to the first university that showed an interest in you, and vice versa. If you're in the UK and your local uni contacted you, you wouldn't just go, okay, that sounds good, I'll go for it. So the whole point of our kind of personal methodical support to the whole process is to make sure that you as a player end up at the right school for you, not just as a footballer or an athlete, but also as an academic as well. So you know, it's really important to make sure that you find yourself at the right school, because as I said, even though it is an amazing experience, say, you know, experience shows that within that first year is most difficult for our international players maybe acclimatizing to it. But if you're in a place where, you know, the sport's good, the academics is challenging you, you're surrounded by like-minded people, and it often helps if there's other internationals as well, then there's a high probability that you're going to want to, you know, stay there for your 4 years and progress. And as I said, America just opens up so many doors for you that about a third of our players go on to become, you know, assistant coaches and do their master's degree, or you know, at least around another third are in a situation like yourself, Matt, where you've been able to kind of pass your skills and expertise on to the next generation by coaching. So I know it sounds kind of cliche, but it really is like an unbelievable life-changing experience. Even myself, okay, I'm not now living in the States, but I'm still, you know, able to run my own business that's grown from 3 people to having over 50 people work for us, you know, worldwide, and which is really rewarding, being able to kind of provide that support, you know, support for people in those exit routes.
That's it, mate. Great insight, mate, and great expertise. Obviously, just reviews, isn't it? Apologies in the States if it was a little bit choppy. I mean, it kind of sums up the whole route, really, doesn't it? Kind of from coming out to the States, where if you don't go with the right person, the whole route can be a bit choppy. So if the signal and stuff cut out a little bit, we apologise. But I think we've got 95% of it, Liam. So again, great insight, mate. And again, I'm just going to kind of go back for it now. Obviously, again, Liam, you're giving obviously great insight into your whole role now, and obviously the stuff you do for players. And again, the importance of someone, again, you touched on myself, who is kind of like the US representative, such a one of, because obviously the company is growing at such a rate, and some of myself who kind of thought, you know, I don't really want to go through a company as such, I want to kind of do it myself. I mean, I put all the legwork in, ladies and gentlemen. Obviously I went and spoke to a lot of universities, and I did it all myself, and I kind of skipped the companies. I wanted to try and save myself money. But looking back at it now, obviously I kind of found a lot of people who I met, and it helps out. But the legwork is colossal, and obviously if you're new into it, you think, oh yeah, I can go and do it. I mean, you can do it. As someone that has done it, it's definitely doable, but it takes so long, guys. And obviously as well, on the flip side, you know, again, like Liam says to me, my first year, I was paying $6,500 in my first year, whereas the cost to kind of be represented by Liam for the whole five-year duration, is a lot less. So to be honest, me, looking back at it now, I probably should have gone through one of these companies. But again, you're looking for that service, because ultimately you are paying for a service, and it does save you money. But if you're not going to get the right service, then that's a problem. Again, just Liam, want to touch on that, mate. Obviously, really the actual service you provide for guys, obviously what sets your company apart, because again, like anything, mate, there is competition out there, and obviously I've been approached by a lot of companies like yourself who are trying to recruit, but I've kind of come on board with you because again, we've got guys in positions who have been there and done it. And obviously, you know, that's not the be all end all, but the service that we, and as I say, we obviously as a representative of the company that we offer to guys who, you know, they pay their money. It's not a case that, oh yeah, here's your money, thanks, see you later. We're not kind of cowboys. We bring people in, we enlighten them on of the whole thing, and we're doing podcasts now, and we bring them in from the start of whatever level they've been at. It's not just about pro level, it's about whatever level you've been. We bring them in, obviously, we enlighten them how to do it. Just talk about the service that you offer, Liam, from start to finish, and the value for money, mate, if you could.
Yeah, I think you made a real key point there. It's just really looking at it as like a long-term investment in yourself, because, you know, at the end of it, you're going to come out with potentially, like myself and you did, Matt, you know, debt-free with a degree that's going to set you up for the next step, you know, in your life, whether that's still involved in sport or whether that's not. And like Matt said, there are various options that you can do, and you could do it yourself even. But obviously, in terms of American college sports, they're just growing in popularity year after year. And even with new, you know, developing sports like rugby, which is growing so quickly. So as you can imagine, these American coaches are absolutely inundated with videos and interest from players that want to play for them, probably to the point where they actually haven't got chance to go through them all. So first and foremost, we've got, you know, personal relationships with these coaches, so we can kind of cut through the noise. And not only that, because we're obviously renowned for sending the best student athletes, they're always going to want to watch our players and have a discussion about them. So first and foremost, it kind of, we let you open the door to even be have that exposure to coaches. But then, like Matt's saying, it's really kind of the support, not only from there but throughout the entire process. So going back to my experience in terms of with negotiations, for example, I thought I had a good deal with full tuition, but it didn't match tuition increases. No doubt on the back end of our current situation, unis aren't going to put their fees up. So what was a zero cost towards tuition by my fourth year was a $4,000 cost. And again, I was quite fortunate that I was able to work on campus. So for those of you listening that are international students, and I'm pretty sure you did as well, Matt, there are opportunities to work on campus with your student visa. You know, that can be a real key way and a differentiator between two schools if you're stuck between deciding which one to go for. Because if that can contribute, I mean, I was quite fortunate. I was earning like $8,000 to $10,000 a year by either working in the gym or as a student assistant. That pretty much effectively covered all my costs for food and housing as well. So, you know, as I said, when I went into the negotiations, the coaches already knew what I could afford. So I didn't really have much leeway there anyway. And then, as I said, all the coaches were contacting me directly, so I wasn't really even able to sound anything off anyone or get that advice. As I said, because we only sign 25 male, 25 female cohort each year, we're able to provide that personal support. So we're having WhatsApp groups with you and your parents and making sure there's a touch point every week. We're having, you know, monthly face-to-face or if not Skype calls to make sure everything's progressing well. We also have, as part of our athletes package, we'll have like a joint spreadsheet with you. So if a coach does happen to make contact with you directly, we can tell you, you know, all the ins and outs in terms of location, sports, roster size, record, what the cost could be, what the scholarship offer could be, our experience working in the past, if we've got players there already. So, you know, so that you're not like me or you, Matt, having to research hundreds of schools and try and negotiate discussions with 50 schools, you're already at a point where, you know, there's one spreadsheet where you can say, okay, these 20 are a good fit for me academically and athletically, and I'm going to invest my time in them, as opposed to schools where I'm wasting their time as well as my own trying to, you know, make a deal happen that's never going to be financially feasible or going to be a good fit for you academically and athletically. So it's really just providing that support throughout the 4 years. And like Matt said, you're essentially signing up to our service, and it's not just about getting you out to America. Actually, the real important thing is making sure that you're happy, you know, for the duration, the whole 4 years. What, you know, the business that we're in is not just getting players out to America. It's about getting, you know, players to graduate and kind of helping them on their next step in their career, which is really the rewarding part for us. So whether it's booking flights, we've got partners that can help get discounted flights. We've got insurance partners that can help if you haven't, if you're not fully covered while you're playing at there, that can help with the insurance. We've got a network of SAT tutors that can provide SAT support. So literally, if there's any part of the whole process of going out to America and also while you're out there that you need help with, we've got, you know, great people on board like Matt and other people working in the States. So, you know, even the time zone, as much as I love to hear from our players at 2 a.m, at least they know they've got someone on the same time zone in them as well. So like Matt said, it's fundamentally 24/7 support for 5 years, and probably some players get sick of hearing from us while they're out in America, but, you know, everyone's different in terms of what support they want.
No, that's it, mate. Great expertise. And again, it's that old age-old cliche, Liam. Obviously, you know, you can't buy expertise. I mean, with this, you literally can. And obviously, if you don't kind of, you know, without trying to sound too forceful, I mean, the facts are and the consequences are, as someone, again, like you, mate, who, I mean, I went and did it all myself. If you don't kind of go with one of these companies and a good company, you are going to end up paying a hell of a lot of money compared to what you would anyway if you went with someone like you. I mean,
yeah.
You know, for me, I probably spent probably 3 or 4 times more in my first year than what I would have for the whole duration had I have gone with someone like yourself. But on the flip side, you have to make sure that the service is right, and obviously the fact that us guys have come through it's massive. And I say it's not just the playing side or even the school side. I mean, it's a whole cultural change. And again, I want to kind of touch upon that, mate, the whole cultural change. Obviously, as guys have come out a bit from a high level in England and whatnot. I mean, again, we're looking at, you know, the going out to school and the student athlete, and obviously the emphasis on student, and again looking at the meals and your housing and then your tuition and even kind of things which people don't know. And obviously myself, who put all the work in, was trying to find out and talking to as many guys as I could. I mean, even little things like the visa, which you have to sort out, and the actual type of visa as an F1 student, which you are, you can't legally work off campus. So there's all sorts of rules, and even with that, guys, give you a little bit of insight there. You know, working on campus, as Liam said, you can earn money, but you're only actually allowed to work for 20 hours a week on campus. So you have to make sure you get a very good role at the school, which, again, there are roles there for you. But if you don't go through someone that's kind of helped you, you're gonna go from being where you could be at the top of the line with someone like Liam, who's got the expertise, to the bottom of the queue. And you end up in a place like me, where I went out to Oklahoma at first, and I was promised the world as such by my coach, and I got out there and the reality was very different, and I found myself where I thought I was going to be coach and I thought I was going to be doing this, that and the other, and I literally was just treated like one of the rabble, and I had to go and find my own way, and I ended up working in a different position for a little while to kind of help and fend for myself. And just things like that, Liam, obviously the cultural change and the nitty gritty, let's kind of really get into that now, mate. And obviously in terms of the whole cultural shift and how you cope with it, obviously again the service, I want to emphasise that word service that you offer to guys to make sure that the mistakes and what that you made and obviously the problems you had to go through, we can now eliminate and help kind of give guys the best experience possible, because it is a fantastic experience, but without the right insight it can be a bit of a nightmare, mate, can't it?
Yeah, definitely. So I think, like you said, it can be a huge cultural shock, and like, you know, you might speak the same language, but, you know, being from someone from Suffolk in England to then living in downtown Chicago is going to be always a culture shock for you. So again, the way that we operate, and whether it's using our online database or obviously utilizing your actual designated rep, or you know, all of our players are free to speak to anyone in the team to listen to their expertise. Anyone going into our process, they kind of know what to expect already. We've already been through the process of providing our insight and guidance on the university. They've had their Skype calls or face-to-faces with the coaches, and we'd always encourage them to also chat to the other international players on the team as well to make sure that, you know, you've got a real grasp on what you're going into. Because, as I said, it's easy to sell the idea of going to America and a place up there where, you know, it's weather, there's beaches, there's playing at a high level, you're playing in front of more people, you're getting a degree. You know, everything sounds amazing, but making sure, you know, it is worthy, because being in Nebraska, it's going to be different to living in California or Florida. And again, it's just a fact find if the right decision for you. So for anyone listening, in fact, as I said, we talked about the online package. You know, even if at this stage you're thinking, oh, I don't know if I want to go to the UK or I don't know if I want to go to the US, just want to explore that option. You know, sign up to our online package. As I said, you can search all the universities on there. You can also create your own profile. So coaches, you know, hundreds of coaches log into our site every week. So create yourself a profile. It's literally, I think it's at the minute, it's £9.99. But for anyone who's listening, use the code LAUNCH50 and you get 50% off that. Even if you just use it for a couple of weeks and just really figure out whether that's for you, or if you want to organise a free player consultation with myself or Matt, we're happy to help. But as Matt said, there isn't really a culture shock if you do it the right way. So if you're spending weeks researching the right schools with us and having those discussions and making sure it's the right thing for you, then no doubt you won't be in the experience of myself and Matt where, yes, I did enjoy my time and I didn't transfer in the end because the company didn't help me. Would I have gone to that school if I knew what I did now? Definitely not. I probably could have played at a higher level in terms of the football side. The academics were great. And as Matt said, no doubt he wouldn't have gone to the first school he did. Not that it wasn't a good learning experience, because, you know, I think with any of these things, you take what you can from every experience and help that improve you. I'm sure Matt then appreciated it more when he moved on to another school. But, you know, we're not in the aim of... I talked about transfers being a great opportunity, but look, at the end of the day, our aim is to send you to a school where you're going to be happy and think, you know what, this is the right school for me for 4 years, where I can develop as an athlete, I can develop as a person, and also for my professional career, set me up for the next stage. So, like Matt said, whether you're a US citizen listening and wanting to come to the UK, or whether you're a UK citizen looking to go to the US on a scholarship, it's all about that service. It's all about getting that information from day one, being transparent, have somebody, you know, it can be a daunting prospect and there is a lot to it. But if you've got somebody who, you know, has been through the process, they've got a team who are expertise in eligibility, entrance exams, insurance, admissions, negotiations, transfers, then, you know, as you, and not only that, like my mum's a massive worrier. So I know for me, if I'd have got the service that we're giving out, it would, like, it helps for the whole family as well to be confident that, yeah, okay, Matt or Liam are out in America potentially for 4 years, even longer. I've got the right people representing them, because same as if, you know, if you're in the UK and you're a pro footballer, if you didn't have the right agent for you, you know, for you, you probably wouldn't get the right deal for you either there. So even though that part, you know, is a small part of what we do, we're going above and beyond, and essentially, you know, we're taking a one-time fee for our elite athletes, but they're getting a minimum 5 years service. So just going back to what Matt's saying, it really is that personal service that provides a real return on investment. And ultimately, we want to make sure that you're at the right school for you, where you're going to enjoy it.
No, I see it, mate. Again, great insight. Again, touching upon that agency side, mate, where, again, that's kind of what the company is now, obviously, but we're looking to look after players and get them out and get them the best experience, obviously the best value for money, which, you know, it kind of offers them. And I chatted to Alex Gilbert the other day, mate, who's the MK Dons captain, obviously, as both guys that are coming through football and stuff. I mean, agents get a bad rep, and rightly so, because there are a lot of Cowboys out there, and even him talking about pro football, where, you know, you kind of got the piranhas as such, are all sniffing about any kind of talent. And he was just saying, look, you know, him and his dad, there's only so much that you know, even in pro football, as someone that's kind of been in England going from the start, and you do need that little bit of help, but at the same time, it's again that key word balance, guys, which we've mentioned a lot on podcasts, where you need to be able to have, you know, the expertise you need, but again, trying to get the right expertise, because there are a lot of guys out there who will, you know, take your money and sell it down the alleyway, and again, with the whole service, the whole package, again, it's as much as it's the college coaches that are going to get a great player, again, the service is for the players. You know, the players are getting looked after the most here. We you know, that the company acts upon your behalf, and it's all about your personal interest and your development to go and get the best insight. So just kind of what would you kind of advice would you give to players and parents, Liam? Obviously, you've given great insight on here, mate, in terms of how the company works and the reasons for it, and obviously the pitfalls and the pros and cons. I mean, what insight now would you give to parents who have listened to the call and they're liking what they hear, or they're a little bit unsure? I mean, what would you kind of say to them to really kind of allow them to go with you guys and allow you to represent them for the whole 5 years?
Yeah, and it kind of reiterates what I mentioned there earlier. It's just all about the information. Like when I went out in the early 2000s, I think we pretty much had dial-up internet. So, you know, in terms of actually research schools, it was cool. But now you've got no excuse at all. And there's like and our website, sports, got on. There's an information on there. We've got free in terms. There's a universe for free. Look at the information on the pro. Line. So, like, if I'm looking next year, what to get done? But hopefully, for the who are sure about Rue, after listening to this, you realise that there is a lot more that goes in than just school and the go deal with this different factors and hurdles that you've got to come in order there. So, someone's listening right now and thinking, "Oh, I'd like to go out, you know, next year." Well, there's never a better time to kind of start that journey now. Speaking, so I was somebody. Late, I think it was months before go out, and it was stressful. And as I said, going into it, not even knowing really where I was going, what I was doing, definitely didn't research the weather before I moved. Shocked from got my sweats on and had about the snow. Yeah, it really is important to get it. So, as I said, to go on the station on there, situating what costs could. On the diff, whether it's N or NAI, the 4 year, don't NJ if you're looking at college. So goes the podcast, there's like Matt's good as well. So the reason why I'm working with people well is because I'm just keen to help people and provide valuable in, you know, based on our own says whether they add so that everyone kind of learn from them. So I guess the key thing for parents is, you know, whether it's looking online, for example, on our website, or signing up to just our online package so you can learn more, or booking a free player consultation with people like myself and Matt who have been there and done that, there really is no excuse. And so it's not only just looking for the information, but it's just preparing, because, as I said, if you know that could be an option for me in 2 years, start the process now. There's no essential cost to it, you know, figuring out what you'd like to do. And, you know, companies like us can provide you all the information you need just to make sure that, you know, it is the right decision for you. Don't get me wrong, going to, you know, overseas to play soccer and go to college isn't for everyone. You know, we do try and sign players that end up, you know, deciding it isn't for them. But why would kind of speak to Matt, speaking with some players that we know ourselves recently. So, you know, we come up with players who maybe decided America won't be an option for them. Down the line, you catch up with them playing again. They'll say, "Oh, I wish I would have done that looking back." You know, and hindsight's a great thing. And I guess the thing that speaks volumes is that I personally would never send anyone, know anyone, been, you know, got service and been and graduated. I wish I'd have never gone to America to study. So I guess that kind of volumes in for the still in education or taking a gap. It can be like a once opportunity, but the longer you're out of it, and then it can cause you some eligibility. So it's an opportunity, and as in terms of our support, it's an investment in that opportunity, because it's the right one.
No, that's it, my great stuff. Apologies for listeners there if it kind of got a bit choppy, but, you know, just to touch on what Liam said, obviously it is a massive cultural change, it is a difference, and again, the longer you kind of leave it, the more susceptible and vulnerable you leave yourself to not get the kind of score and what you need, because obviously playing out in the States and even playing back home at levels, I mean, in the States, especially at a collegiate level, I mean, you're looking at 18 to 23, 24 is the time you want to be out and playing. Obviously, if you wait any longer than that, you know, your eligibility will cost you. And obviously, even as a young guy, I mean, people are like, well, what age should I really start to look at it, really? And again, you can look from any age you want. You know, kind of 13, 14, you want to have half an eye on it, just in case. And the service like Liam, obviously, you know, the company's offering is a massive insight. And again, we'll drop Liam's contact information in the bio, in the description underneath this call. And again, obviously, we apologise if it's been a little bit choppy, but Liam's in a bit of a rural area in England, in Suffolk. So again, we got a lot of the call and a lot of insight. But for more information, do reach out to him directly, and I'm sure he will. I know for a fact he'll be able to help you in terms of both sides of it, on the Atlantic, kind of getting you from the US to the UK, if that's where you want to go, or from the UK to the US, or even branching out around the world, where there are so many contacts and links now that Liam's established, where he's getting different players out to different parts of the world. And it is for boys and girls, so it's a whole array of talent being kind of looked after and shipped around the world, and not kind of left to die as such, or maybe as we were when we first went out, but, you know, really kind of getting set up for success rather than for failure. So Liam, really, really good having you on the call, mate. You know, again, just before you leave, have you got anything you'd like to leave listeners with, and anything you'd like to kind of say just before we finish the call?
Yeah, no, I really enjoyed catching up with you, and I find it beneficial. And as I said, you know, going to America, or whether you're looking to play from America, said throughout, it is a big decision, but, you know, we've got all the information and resources and support you need to just decide if that is the right thing for you. As I said, it's not for everyone, but, you know, speaking firsthand and for myself and Matt, obviously it's been a life-changing experience, and obviously it could be for you as well.
No, great stuff, mate. Great insight, Power, and I really appreciate you taking time on the call, mate.
No worries. Thanks, everyone. Stay safe.